Secret Stream Engage. Welcome, welcome. It's playing against Atre 5 in the League of Dreams. We're allowed to sideboard. We both have to share a deck list, so he gets to see my deck list in advance. Looked at his list and his sideboard. Decided to include Thoughtheart, the Aegis, and the Divine Judgment from my sideboard into my deck based on him having Arcane Burst and Kaya. So we're going to queue this up now. We're ready. Let's go. Make sure I pick the right list real quick. Go chat. Playing three rounds.
Good luck, Trey.
Hope you're doing well, homie. Well, we take heal always with this deck. Reason being, it's just like, if your goal is to stabilize and live till you play the coconut and then live after, the strength reduction is nice, but healing 2 is more than the strength reduction 1. When I first started playing this deck, I would use the strength reduction. I tried it and then just came to the conclusion that heal just buys you more time if your end goal with the deck is to stabilize and buy time until you can stick the coconut combo. Kill this creature. I could use Divine Judgment on it, but I'm saving that for Kaya. I know I don't have order yet, but otherwise Kaya's gonna be hard to kill without using like a Lysander's Mercy to reset the board. That's sweet. Okay, so we can stick the coconut next turn. Best card to get from it would be Eris here. Eris, in theory, wins us the match. I'll obliterate most of his deck. It'd be very hard for him to clear it. I think actually at 5, he wouldn't have a way to clear it. It's not possible. Uklis would also be great here because we can clear 4 of his board. Eris. Not the best options. We're at risk of the coconut being transformed, and we don't like the threat. The unacceptable monstrosity is nice stat-wise, but it's not that big of a threat to him right now, especially having a frontline and having protected on God. That's 2 turns of us attacking and doing nothing to his face, which is where we want the damage to go. Face is the place. Faded Arrival would be nice because we could give the coconut ward. Also, might end up sticking Lysander's at 6.5 just to reset the coconut and then get another 9 drop off of it. In theory, if he doesn't play another front line, we can pop protected next turn. But if he went face with his board, he can gain enough favor to grab the rune from the sanctum, which gives his creature front line. Oh, it's Kaya. I grabbed this just for you, Kaya. It's a special present. Just for Kaya. Spells are in his void. 2, 4. Or creatures as well. Give us Ares. I would take Rimnus if I had a Lysander's Mercy, but without that, the worst case scenario where he gets an Eris or Avatar, I would lose from it. Two, four, five spells in the void. Another Lysander's Mercy would be really nice. Or Tuck. for Spells and Void. Lysander's Mercy? No.
I want to use the vow to heal. I'm going to save it. Don't want to use it yet.
A lot of spells. I'm gonna play this now to heal. Still waiting on Lysander's, the Lysander's Mercy. I have 10 cards left in deck. Go. Coconut, go! Give us Eris. I have another Born Again. Didn't want to just do nothing this turn. Oh, he has Arcane Burst in the deck. That's 6 cards, 6 spells in Void. I need heals. Heals. Huge. I needed this way earlier in this Aegis.
Suppose I could have pulled it earlier?
I've only seen one Enlightenment, right? That's kind of odd. Yeah, only seen one Enlightenment at this point in the match. I think we have heals left. Yeah, Arcane Burst. I might die here. I just needed to heal as much as possible, and I have. We'll see what he has here. I'm probably dead, huh? He has another Arcane Burst, I'm dead. Or another Pyrrhic, I'm dead. Yeah. Oh no. Oh, we didn't have exactly 10. Oh my gosh, the Aegis just won us that match. What a win. Oh my gosh, guys, let's go. All right, we got the first one. Why did it queue into that? So I changed my code once the match ended.
That worked out really well. Alright, let's go. Good luck, have fun, Trey. Round two, fight!
This is a pretty good hand against his deck because he has a lot of 1/1s with Echo. Ukos to clear board, dousing first turn. Faded to give it front line, pull it back to hand, give it ward. I'll just hold the relic. Normally it attacks, so I don't pull the coconut closer. But in a scenario where he hasn't played Safeguard Incantation, wait. In theory, we might be able to pop the protect that he gains from it if we hold the relic. Play another one. Pip out and play another Echo. Give us Ares this match. Huge play here. So we want this heal based on this matchup. We know he's going to try to do a lot of face damage, so we're going to take the vow to heal later. Give us Ares. Ares. Come on, Heart of the Cards.
Baby Ares.
Let's go.
The power of the coconut in the palm of our hands, chat. Are you not entertained?
Love it, guys. Just love it. Existential crisis occurring on Trey's side of the board, I'm sure. I would too. Whenever I see Ares, I mean, how could you not? Turn 6. Turn 6, Ares. His best move is to kill all of his creatures and not do what he just did.
You didn't want to give us more targets to attack there.
Gonna heal first. So he only has the cards in his hand now. Whatever those cards may be. Palace Snow Shaper still. That's rough. I don't want him having this relic removal. I should still win this from fatigue, I think? Question mark? Fortunately, we have an answer to that. Yeah, we got him again. GG, bro. I was worried about that Snow Shaper. Eris just pulled us in clutch there. Oh, do you have us? Are you... No. There ain't no way, right? Maybe he does. Or no, yeah. GG, bro. Good game, Trey. Let's go again. Aw, yeah, chat. Imagine being able to look at their deck list. What's that like all the time? Good luck, Trey. Have fun. Let's go, bro. One second. Okay. We want this, but not yet. Take this. Enlightenment, this is goated right here. Absolutely goated hand. Okay, use this pip turn one. Playing this sensor before the one order expires buys us a third turn of them not being able to attack. That's all he has right now, so I'm okay effectively preventing all damage. I know it's nice to have a sensor in case when we get to Akaya potentially, but if I just hold a Val, it'll be okay. Ukos would go so hard here. I could play Guiding Light and then Ukos. No, didn't get it. See if we can't bait Iko here. I don't want to play this yet for obvious reasons. Iko reasons. Give us Eris again. Eris. Come on, Eris. Sweet baby Eris. 6 pound, 9 ounce. Baby Eris. Avatar magic's pretty huge. Probably looking for his transforms now. He doesn't need to know we don't have a one mana spell in hand. He hit us with the GG, we'll hit him back. He's straight into us so he doesn't have creatures, because they're gonna be targets for beams in a second. But him doing that actually helped us because it gave us enough favor. Otherwise, I'd have had to spend 4 mana to cast my first spell. Which meant I would only be able to play, what, 2 beams? Now I can actually kill him. Good game, Stray. I did not expect to sweep you. I thought you were going to be sweeping me, bro, with that Palace Snow Shaper. Good matches, bro. Good matches. RNGesus was on our side today.
Let's go, chat. Can't see it right now, but I'm flexing. Oh, good games, Trey. Good games, brother.
Fun matches, fun matches. Let's go, bro.
Let's go, chat.
Surprise match is over. Catch you guys next time. Take care of yourself. Take care of each other. Love you guys. Peace.